inaugural class for AIM High. We are super excited to welcome these young people into this amazing opportunity. We're gonna get started because we're a little behind time. We wanna thank the parents for getting here on time. We wanna thank you guys for cooperating. And without further ado, I wanna introduce the founder, CEO, the man in charge of AIM High, Mr. Sherman Brown.
And I am glad to take part in this exciting day, especially because of the fact that we are making history right here at Pelham Gardens Middle School. You see, AIM High has been running for a number of years, but never did we have a middle school component of AIM High. And when I met your wonderful principal the minute that we came here and she saw what the program was about, she said right away, "We ready?" Those are her first words to me. She said, "We want to make sure that we have this here, not just for the young men, but also for the young women." And today you're going to see these young men and young women, many of them who you sit in classrooms with, many of them who you see on a regular basis. And them being a part of AIM High doesn't say that they are perfect. But what it does say is that they are committed to making progress. Now, your principal just said a while ago something that I think is very important: good vibes only. And for those of you who are in this room today, I'm gonna need you to pay attention to this ceremony and what's happening here. I'm gonna start off with something that might be a little heartfelt. A young man passed away about a week ago by the name of Nipsey Hussle. And when Nipsey Hussle passed away, listen up, when he passed away, the unfortunate incident was it was somebody from his same community, the community that he was trying to help, is who took him out. And I start off with that because although somebody in here or some of you in this room may not be pulling out a gun to shoot another student, sometimes your words could be gunshots. Sometimes the things that you say could be gunshots. Sometimes the little whispering on the side to try to hate on those who are trying to make some moves, those could be gunshots as well. And we're not about that life here. That you are giving your undivided attention to what's happening in this ceremony. If you don't have anything positive to say, then do me a favor, don't say anything at all. But don't be a distraction to anyone who is in this room. Because these students who are standing here before you today, who will walk in this room today, you gotta understand that as the world turns, they all go through pain and struggle. But they still juggle with the hope of being successful tomorrow. Some thought they wouldn't make it, but they were sadly mistaken. The journey's just begun and they're quickly accelerating to higher heights. These students are going to higher heights with a vision beyond sight. They're so bright that many are blinded by their light, shining stars. They are shining stars and they are doing their thing. Pelham Gardens Middle School, keep doing your thing, and as you do it, we will rebuke all negativity. Take steps forward and make those dreams a reality. Pelham Gardens will be in the house right now.
Yeah! levels in this room right now. Now listen up. For the last few months, myself and many members of this team have had the distinguished opportunity to work with these young people. And I am so proud to just see the progress that these young people have made. Even when they heard, "Why are you staying after school for Aim High? Why are you a part of that?" They kept on going. They kept on striving, and they continue to fight to make a better life for themselves and for their families. And because they are doing that, that is why when we were setting up this event, we said, we can't just let them look nice and spiffy for the school alone. We gotta invite the parents, the ones who support them through this process. So do me a favor, I need all the Pelham Garden Middle School students to give a round of applause for all of these parents who are just here. So we're gonna take you on time for New York. So we're gonna take you on time for some of your other duties to be here today. Don't get it twisted, guys. We are so grateful for all of them. And although AIM High as an organization is here and we're working with these students week after week, we know that it wouldn't be possible without the support of some very spectacular and very powerful people. Now, these people, you see them on a regular basis. And what I always tell people, especially when I'm talking to students, is that when you see a teacher or a counselor or a parent standing in front of you, that person is more than just their title. They have their lives, they have their issues, they have their things that they're going through, but yet they come here day by day, dedicated and committed to making sure that you go to another level. So when AIM High came to the school, we never said to ourselves that we would just work with the students alone. We wanted to be integrated with everyone. And these folks have stepped up time and time again to make sure that they are there to be what I call M&Ms. And M&Ms are not the bite-sized candies, but these individuals have decided to be mentors and models. And every time they sit with these students, they give them some M&Ms. And those M&Ms are the methods that work for them to become successful and the mistakes that these students need to avoid. Those M&Ms are sweet. And it's something that if all of you understand here, that no matter where you are in life, there's somebody who's already done it before you. And it would be beneficial for you to always stay connected to those folks and to learn from them. So at this time, before we induct the students who are here today, we want to officially induct all of the AIM High coaches who have been spending their time week after week to pour into our students. And I'm going to ask them to stand on their feet right now and come to the front right here. Give them a round of applause. These are the
right? When we first started Akon, she was a little bit nervous, but she became engaged. She became empowered. And now she's living this life by design, and she's here to tell you her story. So once more, I'm going to hand the mic to her. And again, it's an absolute pleasure to bring her to the front of the room. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Maxwell. Good morning, Davis. my father is worried about Father's Day. I know that today some of us in this room have lost people that we really love, and some of our brothers have lost their parents. AMI has become a supportive, encouraging, cooperative experience for me. And it's not about what you lost, it's about how much you have left. Our AMI coaches have helped in my swing and empowering my fellow brothers and I. And these fellow brothers over here, they have been bright, friendly, and hard with them. Our AMI affirmation states, we are known with ambition, inspiration, and motivation. Our attitudes and actions will transform my nation. This quote tells us that whenever you say the word ambition, we will have success. We will have both power and knowledge. AMI has provided me with more confidence, more power, and pride. Thank you, everyone.
We are so proud for all of these young people who worked here today. And you guys have waited long enough. And now is the moment. I'm going to ask Ms. Rose White and Assistant Principal Mr. Morgan to come forward at this time as we officially induct the members of the AMI Empowerment Institute right here on Pelham Middle School.
Yeah, blessings we are reap and we course in handful. Oh, we no rise and boast. Yeah, we give thanks like we need it the most. We have to give thanks like we really supposed to be thankful. Blessings all for my life and my thank God for the journey, the earnings, not just for the plus. Yeah, and gratitude is a must. Yeah, we see blessings fall by my right hand. But a toast for the friends we take off.
Listen up. At the end of every AMI meeting, we usually close off with what we call, listen up, our AMI Empowerment Affirmation. These are the words that are said every meeting to remind themselves of who they are and who they will become. So at this time, I'm going to pass it over to Ms. Cherise Brown, who's going to lead the young women in their AMI Empowerment Affirmation.
Living is not by design. We move forward together. No man left behind.
What?
No man left behind.